Hey, how's it going? Sean D. Stewart, founder of The Creative Track and creator of Simplify, 6 weeks to stress-free productivity. And in today's video, we're gonna talk about what are the 7 crucial components of building a streamlined business so that you can operate your company like a well-oiled machine, all right? And get out from under the weight of the overwhelm and really wearing too many hats in your business that's really causing you the frustration and stress. Right? So as well, we're gonna talk about a little later, what are the 10 most frequently asked questions that I get about how to master your time? All right, so we're gonna jump into that, but first of all, I just wanna thank everybody who's watched the videos that I put out so far and commented and sent me the emails and posted on Facebook. I'm really grateful that you watched them and that you implemented them and that you're able to use them to help your business immediately. And if you didn't watch them, well, I just wanna really quickly cover what we talked about. In the first video, we talked about the weekly reset so that you can learn how to be proactive about your week ahead of time, determining what are the big rocks that you need to focus on, and then going about and focusing on them, right? And I built you out a system for how to do that. And in the second video, I talked about a whole different side of time management, really the inner game of productivity, and specifically how to supercharge your focus by creating a powerful morning ritual that's gonna get your energy up and be able to help you be a higher performer in business, which is definitely gonna affect your productivity. All right, so what I wanna talk to you about is actually 2 mindset pieces before we jump in, because it's really important to lay the groundwork about what we're going to cover here. The first mindset piece is important to understand because I feel that too many entrepreneurs that I talk to, they constantly tell me they've got too much on their plate and they're rushing and, you know, they're multitasking to get it all done. And so the first mindset I want to say is that a really important part of good productivity is actually to give yourself less to do and to celebrate what you do accomplish, all right? So it's really common for people to try to get a week's worth of work done in a day, or to try to get 2 years worth of work done in 1 year, right? Like we're really trying to do too much. And so I just wanna suggest that part of good time management is actually feeling productive. And nothing makes you feel productive like being able to pat yourself on the back and say, I had 3 things I was gonna do today and I got them done, all right? And to celebrate that win. And then the other mindset is for you to actually think out more strategically in the long term of your business so that you can actually plan out something so you can get everything that you wanna get done, right, in your business, but not at this moment, right? Not at one time. Because I really feel that we are living in an era where most people are caught up in really short-term gratification. You know, we want it all now. And another way of looking at this is really the shiny object syndrome. You know, we really want that new thing, we're gonna buy it because we think it's gonna produce this result, but then we don't even implement, right? So I think we're really running around trying to get too much done too fast, and in the process, either it takes us way longer to get there, or we actually never get there because we give up or our business folds or whatever it is, right? So again, the 2 mindsets is really to do less in the short term and to celebrate your wins, and then to have a more strategic plan in the long term so that you can map out what you're gonna do and not have to feel like you're trying to do 2 years worth of work in a year, all right? So those are really important mindsets. All right, now a lot of my clients, they tell me, Sean, I'm just not good at time management. And these are people that are either just starting their business or they have 6-figure businesses and they feel like they don't have the structure, and they tell me that all the time. And really, after I talk to them and, you know, I get, you know, clear on what their goals are and everything, I find out that actually it's not that they're not good at time management or they don't have structure, it's really that they don't know what the right things are to focus on, all right? They're caught up in what Stephen Covey calls the thick of thin things, all right? So it's like they're really caught up in those pebbles, if you watch that other video, and not the big rocks. What are those crucial needle movers, right, in your business that are going to produce the most results? That's good time management, all right? So I just wanna help you to understand how to figure out what those things are, and I wanna give you really an understanding of how to build your business into a well-oiled machine. So that's what we're gonna talk about today. But the first thing I want to talk to you about is really the number one word that you need to know in business. So I'd love to ask you, what is the number one word that you need to know? If I was to ask you this in, let's say, one of my telesummits or teleclasses, I should say, or in one of my live or speaking events, I would say, what is it? You know, and put you on the spot. And you might say, oh, it's customers, right? Or it's revenue. Maybe you'd say it's passion because we're heart-centered, right? Well, those are great words, but those are not the word. So what is the word? Well, this word is going to be, you know, I want you to keep it in mind because it's going to make the biggest difference. And I said it earlier, and I'll say it a lot. It's one of my favorite words, but this is really kind of a main component, structural piece of this formula that I'm going to talk to you about today. So what is that word? Well, that word is strategy. Okay. So strategy is really about having the end in mind, right? Being able to have the 50,000 foot view of your business, looking out 2 or 3 years and determining what are your marketing strategies, right? What are your relationship building strategies or your list building strategies? What is your brand strategy? What are the products that you're planning on selling within that brand, right? What's your sales funnel, right? And just having that clarity of the strategy of your business, it gives you that big picture view, all right? And this is really important because as we step into the first column here and step number two, because this step number two is goals and plans, okay? So we've got a strategy in place. We know what we're actually going towards, and we reverse engineer that strategy backwards. We say, okay, here's the end in mind. So let's say that's a 2-year end in mind. So now we can say half of that is the 12-month goals, right? So here we are right now. It's actually the end of 2013. And so, you know, if you haven't already, you're getting ready to create your 12-month goals. And it's really important that you have the strategy in place first so that, again, you can not do 2 years of work in 1 year. And this way we can set your year up to not be overwhelming, but to be strategic in terms of your overall plan and leave you the space in your schedule to be able to produce higher quality products or services or have the time in your schedule to, you know, have the quality of life that you deserve. So I like to say that it's important to have 3 major goals for a given year and that you should have 3 milestones within each one of those goals. And that way we're actually continuing to reverse engineer from the strategy into the 12-month goals. And then with the milestones, we're looking at our 6-month really goals, right? Because those are milestones. Those are the 6-month halfway points to the main goals and then our 3-month goals. And we're really zooming down closer into, you know, our day, right? But we're getting that overview picture. All right, so now we're really getting really the structure, you know, and this is a container, if you will, that can hold you in place so that you can, you know, have really productive business without trying to do too much at once. And it really leads nicely into this next pillar, which is about going inside now. And this is why we're gonna talk about really self-management, which is really the inner game of productivity, which I did talk about in the last video. If you haven't watched it, you can still watch it, it's above. So self-management, what is it, right? Well, Stephen Covey said, you know, the time management is a misnomer. The challenge is to manage ourselves. What did he mean by this? Well, when we say that time is the problem, we're actually relinquishing responsibility for what it is, the part we play in our time scarcity issues. And what I see a lot of times with entrepreneurs is I see them, you know, saying that they don't have time, but when you take a closer look, you find that they procrastinate on the most important things in their business, those needle movers, right? They don't do them. Now, why don't they do them? Well, they're not fun, you know, they're boring, whatever it is, you know, maybe they cause some emotional disturbance. You know, I've had some entrepreneurs tell me that jumping into, let's say, doing this important thing for their business, it made them feel like they weren't smart, you know, and who wants to feel like they're not smart? So let's go do the things that we're good at, right? But that's actually not going to help your business. So we need to work on self-management, and that's really about aligning, you know, the mind, the emotions, and the body, and get them all kind of talking to each other and working at a high optimal level so that you can actually make smarter choices and be able to focus on those challenging things and have the discipline to focus on them, even if it's not fun. Because Albert E. N. Gray, he said, you know, the common denominator of success is that successful people are willing to do the things in their business that are hard. They're willing to make habits out of those things, whereas unsuccessful people, they're not willing to do that. So are you willing to do the challenging things that are going to move the needle for you and your business? If not, then it's really important that you work on your self-management. So that's how you're going to get to be able to do that. So let's talk about what's the next step. So we've got the container, and now with that container we started to work on ourselves. And then really this next part is actually something I covered in a previous video, but now we're kind of zooming in from the 2-year strategy kind of overview, 50,000 foot view, into the 30,000 foot view of the 12-month goals, and even closer foot view of basically the 3- and 6-month goals, right? And now we have kind of got that container in place, and now we have the weekly and daily planning. So we've got this structure, and what we have here is the ability to, again, do the weekly reset and decide what are our big rocks and be proactive about our schedule, you know, and really make decisions about what it is we're going to do, and then go out and do them. With the self-management now in place, we'll actually take the actions we need to take. Now, daily planning is another piece of this, and this is what most people are doing. You know, they don't have any of this other stuff in place. They might have some goals, right? But it's not too structured. But they have a plan, a daily plan. Maybe they have a daily planner, or they have to-do lists, you know? That's I have a strategy for that, but it's related to the weekly plan. So you've got your results template, and then now with the daily plan, what you're gonna do is you're going to decide which of those things you're gonna do, and you're gonna make your plan for the day, all right? And it's not the same as a to-do list, but I really believe that you can use daily planning and weekly planning to help your business be really productive and successful. All right, so the next pillar here is something that I think is important to kind of give a little bit of prep for, which is that, you know, I find that entrepreneurs, one of their biggest challenges is giving away tasks. You know, we want to free up our time, but it's easier to complain about it than actually kind of relinquish control and give away things that we shouldn't be doing in our business. A mentor of mine said, you know, only do what only you can do. But in this case, what we're talking about is putting in place systems for you to be able to document important things going on in your business that you don't want to keep doing. You're going to do them over and over again, but you don't want to have to deal with the friction of all the possible moving parts. So you lock it into, let's say, a checklist, and then you can just pull that checklist up and follow those procedures and save yourself a lot of time, or be able to hand that checklist over to somebody on your team, and they're going to be able to do it for you. So systems, there's a lot of different types of systems. Specifically, I'm talking about, you know, kind of the procedures and, you know, the operations manuals of your business. And putting down the checklist, right? But the question I have for you is, you know, do you know what the top 10 systems are for your business? You should know them. And in my Simplify program, I'm gonna cover each one of those in detail. But it's really important that you have systems in place in your business. All right, so let's talk about the next step. The next step or pillar in this overall game plan I'm giving you for how to turn your business into a well-oiled machine is actually a system in itself, but it's such an important system that it got its own pillar, because we're living in an era where we can really set in place machines to do the work for us, okay? So now we're not just giving away things by having checklists and procedures or, you know, operation manuals. We actually have automation going on, which is gonna allow us to set something up once and have it just keep working over and over again with absolutely no effort on our part to keep it going. And you might have some automation going on. You might be able to, you know, if you're out of town, have your email immediately say to somebody that emails you that, you know, you'll be out of town for a certain amount of days, and, you know, we've all seen that. But do you have autoresponder emails in place that are building relationships for you while you're sleeping, or even landing clients for you? You know, it's actually having machines work for you. And this is so amazing, because this has never been easier as it is today with the tools and technologies at our disposal. So you know, I'd love for you to step into utilizing more automation in your business, and this is a really important part. All right, so we've got the overall container and really the framework, if you will, of turning your business into a well-oiled machine and getting out from under the overwhelm and the stress and the wearing of too many hats and the complaining that you don't have enough time. And we're stepping into responsibility, right? Self-responsibility, and we're really learning how can we do this. We can do this, guys, and it's really exciting. And it's even more exciting than knowing that you'll have more time or knowing you'll have more time with your family. It's exciting as well to know the kind of freedom in your soul that you'll have to bring to your clients now. And that's what's really exciting, because we're really about transformation, right? And helping individuals to be more successful, but from the inside out, and really transform them. And so this whole thing to me is more than anything, it's a tool for you to be in your best self and really be able to operate at your highest level. So I hope you're excited. Let's talk about the last part. Again, this is a foundational part, just like strategy. What I'm about to talk to you about really is part of all these pieces, but it's kind of something that's going to make all of it go even easier. And we talked about it a little, but specifically we're talking about team, right? We're talking about having a team and delegating responsibility. So who are the right people to have on your team? Well, we'll talk about that in the Simplify program, but basically it's important for you to know that if your hourly rate is $100 an hour, what is it costing you to go and do a task in your business that you could hire somebody to do for $15 an hour? It's costing you $85, right? You saved the 15 that you would have spent on this person, but you used your precious time. And too many entrepreneurs, they know their rate, but they don't value their time. It's really important that, you know, you step out of trying to, you know, control everything, let go, relinquish some control, you know, build the systems, you know, set up the automation, and of course, get your team set. And whether it's, you know, a VA or tech help, or, you know, there's different people that might be right for you, but this is obviously a crucial component to this whole system that I've been talking about today. All right, so I hope that served you. And in a few moments, I'm gonna walk over this table. I'm gonna talk to you about the 10 most frequently asked questions that I get in my business. And these are really questions that you've asked me, all right? These are questions that you know, you've either written in the comments section, or that I've gotten emails, or maybe stuff that I've, you know, heard from my clients over the last 4 years helping them with these challenges. And so you're gonna love this. And if you have any questions, always know that you can put them into the comment box below. And I'd really love to know what you're getting from this and if you're getting value from what I'm giving you today. So, all right, so I'm gonna go over to the table now. All right, well, welcome to Story Hour with Sean D. Stewart. And we're gonna jump into the 10 most frequently asked questions that I get about time management. So what's the first one? Well, the first one is, what if I'm already productive? Will what you're talking about be helpful to me? Well, my guess is that if you've gotten this far in the video, then what I've been training you on today is resonating. And so the answer to that is absolutely. What I'm talking about is going to be helpful for you, whether you are a beginner at time management or you've already been training in it for many years. I've gone through a lot of programs on this subject, and I really believe that what I bring to it is a whole nother level. And that is specifically because there's a spiritual aspect to the way that I teach time management, and I think that's what's going to make it work for you, all right? What if I'm already bogged down in trainings and not implementing? Well, here's the thing. If you're using words like bogged down, my guess is that you are not operating at an optimal level with your time management. So I would suggest that you put down those trainings and you focus on what I'm talking about with you in this training, because you're going to find that you'll be able to go back to those trainings and have a much better system for accomplishing them. So you're in a perfect place if you're bogged down with other trainings. The third most frequently asked question that I get is, can I just hire someone to fix this and outsource this, you know, instead of learning it? Here's my answer to that. No. You cannot outsource time management. You can't outsource. It's a core business skill that you need to learn. And just imagine if you had somebody that was doing like what I was talking about earlier, and kind of doing your strategy, doing your, you know, your goal setting and all the things. Then you would basically have somebody that you were dependent on in your business. And then what happens when that person's no longer around, right? So you can't let that happen. I won't let that happen to you. So no, you cannot outsource this. You have to learn it. All right, I've taken courses and trainings on time management, but they didn't help. Is there really a solution out there for this problem? Right? So I hear what you're saying. You're basically saying, I've tried many things and they didn't actually produce the results that they promised. And here's the thing, I've gone through those courses and I feel you, I feel your pain. And that's why I created this course that I've been talking to you about today. I've created it specifically because I know that these other programs, they're missing pieces. And so I really feel that I filled those missing pieces here. And so you're in the right place. Does improving my time management have a real world return on investment? Well, we're not going to talk about numbers right now, but let's just put it this way. I mean, what's it costing you to have the stress that you have because of, you know, wearing so many hats or having to do so much in your business and really taking on so much? What is it costing you, right? Well, whatever it's costing you, you're going to get that back by learning what I'm going to teach you. How much is it costing you in terms of finances? How much is it costing you in terms of emotions? What is that carrying over to your relationships, and how is that affecting the people in your life and your clients, right? Ultimately, your vibrancy is going to be dampened by not having good time management because there's just this frustration energy, right? So absolutely, there's so many returns on investment, whether it's time with your family or time for vacations or more money or a bigger business or being able to make a bigger impact. Whatever it is, trust me, there is a massive ROI from learning time management. All right, what if I'm too busy to improve my time management? This is a really good one, I love this. So here's the thing, right? If you're too busy, then you're really stuck in the paradigm that I'm hopefully shaking you out of from these trainings. So it's time for you to get out of the too busy mindset and learn a way to not put too much on your plate and actually work smarter, not harder, so that you can have the time to put the quality energy into your life and your business that it deserves, okay? So what I'm teaching you today is so important for you if you're too busy for time management. What I have to say really is take the time to save time. I know it's really maybe something you've heard before, but it's such an important thing to make sure that you take the time. And it might be counterintuitive, but you've got to make stuff like this a priority over, you know, the things in your life that you want and get out of the quick fix and create a solid foundation. I mean, think of a house. A house without a solid foundation is gonna collapse. It's the same with you if you don't have this stuff. So don't let that happen to you. And if you're too busy, you're definitely in the right place. What if I'm a parent with kids and a large family and I'm just, you know, dealing with the challenges of this variable that's constantly changing of you know, dealing with small children or dealing with grown children or whatever. I get it, okay? I've worked with dozens of parentpreneurs, and the stuff that I'm talking about today is also for you. In fact, there's a lot of great stuff that I can teach you and help you with if you're a parentpreneur. And you know, I really feel for you, and I've worked with so many parentpreneurs that I know exactly what it's gonna take for you to get out of that mindset and be able to be productive and feel really good about not only the time you spent in your business, but the time you spent with your family and with your children, right? So you can absolutely gain from this if you're a parentpreneur. Number eight, what if I don't believe in taking massive action and I wanna just manifest, you know, what you're talking about without, you know, a lot of effort? Well, here's the thing. I just want to say there's two energies, right? There's the masculine and the feminine, and they work together. And so you can't have one without the other, okay? You can't just sit back and expect that you can have a business that grows without doing the things that I talked about today, you know, with the strategy and the planning and the inner game and, you know, the weekly planning, all that stuff. It does take work. I mean, it's going to take physical effort. But I really believe that what happens is that the real way that manifestation works is that you put that effort out, you plant that seed, if you will, and then that seed grows and then it ultimately pays you back tenfold. And that's the manifestation process. You do the work of taking the action and then you get to receive the benefits. That's masculine energy, planting the seed and taking that action, and feminine energy of manifestation and receiving. That really is, you know, those two sides. So I really believe that we've got to get out of that misconception that you can only just, that it's okay to just sit back and let these things happen and that things are going to happen. You've got to take action. What if the idea of time management bores me? I love this one. Look, I get it. I mean, time management has bored me before too. But the thing is that I have built habits out of the most important needle moving activities and really core competencies, if you will, of my business. And so that's what's allowed me to grow as fast as I have in my business and accomplish what I have accomplished. So, you know, if you're bored by time management, that's perfectly fine. There's no shame in it. The thing is that going to stop you? Are you going to build the habits that you need to build in order to get the things done that you need to get done, right? So yes, that's fine, but don't let it stop you. All right, number 10, how can you help? All right, well, we've been talking about my upcoming program, Simplify 6 Weeks to Stress-Free Productivity. And I just want to say that this program is soup to nuts, the most comprehensive program on the market for time management. I've really pulled together the best of the best, and I've really added in some components that nobody else out there has. And this is really step by step, and it's something where I'm just taking you by the hand and showing you how I did it, just like I did today. Right, and it's really thinking about the modern entrepreneur that's got just this incredible amount of information to deal with, but at the same time, these incredible new tools, whether we're talking about technology tools or we're talking about the inner game tools, right? This stuff is at our disposal now, so you've got to use it, and that's what this program is all about, right? So let's just talk about real quickly what's covered in the program. Well, the program is really broken down similarly to everything that I talked to you about today. All right, so you're going to go through a goal setting process. That's going to be the first thing that you do in the program, and really get your plan laid out, your 12-month plan, and then the 3 milestones within that. And then from there, we're going to do some self-management. So in the second class, we're going to really break down, you know, how to get the physical, the emotional, and the mental sides of yourself to be working at an optimal level so that you can manage yourself well and change the whole paradigm of time management. All right, and it's just that class in itself just lays an incredible foundation as well. You know, it's really going to teach you, you know, how to focus and how to expand your focus muscle, which is crucial to getting a lot done in your business. The next class is really where we'll break down how to do the weekly and daily planning. So we'll go over again the weekly reset and how to choose your big rocks, and we'll get you implementing that. As well, I'll give you a worksheet for how to have your daily planning be really simplified. And that is something that you can choose to do. You don't have to do both weekly and daily planning, but you can do it if you want, and it's great to have those things at your disposal. As well, we'll talk about in that particular class how to set your office up for maximum productivity, and it's great. I show you a full breakdown of what my office has and how it's set up so that you can basically model what I've done. In the next class, we'll be talking about simplifying the GTD system. So David Allen's great book, Getting Things Done, was really influential to me. And so what I've done is I simplified it, brought it down to its essence, and giving you that and added some components of my own onto it to allow you to get everything off your mind and into external buckets so that you know what you want to do and you can pull out of that buckets and you can choose what your big rocks are and you can constantly have everything kind of moving. So you can focus on what matters most and not get bogged down by the constant inputs, and you know, this, it all works together. So that GTD simplified is incredible. Now, the next thing that we're going to talk about is systems and automation, right? So exactly like we said, we're going to talk about what are the 10 systems that you absolutely need to put in place in your business and what are the automations you need to put in place and how do you do that. And then finally, we're going to pull it all together and get you implementing what we learned, okay? Because this is not just about in one ear, out the other. It's about taking action. It's about producing massive results in your business. I'm all about helping entrepreneurs succeed at the highest level. It's my goal. It's my mission. And so I'm really excited about this program. So I'm looking forward to, you know, letting you know about it when I'm launching. But for right now, if you could just put any comments that you feel, you know, you want to say, if any questions, anything that you got from this underneath this video, I'd really appreciate it. And again, I'll let you know when I'm launching the Simplify course. And that's going to cover it for today. This is Sean Stewart. And don't forget that success is your birthright. So go out there and create it. All right. I'll talk to you soon. Good night.